From Irving High School, it's the ICTN Game of the Week. Tonight, the R.L. Turner Lions against the Irving Tigers. Hi, everybody. Rob Willman with you. John Nelson will join us here in just a minute. Two teams here that were district foes for the last couple of years. Now R.L. Turner dropped down in the classification. Irving reassigned, if you will, to a much tougher district. So they face each other. Instead of twice a year, they'll do it once, and it'll be a warm-up game. Irving, a big winner, 71-61 over Mansfield Legacy to start the season. R.L. Turner playing another taller and tougher team in classification, losing to the Garland Owls 63-41. Take a look at the starting lineups. First of all, for the R.L. Turner Lions, who will be in the blue uniforms, blue and gray with the blue numbers, it's Johnson, Walker, Watson, Serrano, and Mirage. You're starting five. And for the Irving Tigers, some familiar names there: Anthony Union, Trey Nelson, Angel Garcia, Kobe Stokes, and Bailey Williams, a forward, wearing number 33 and playing senior. These Tigers have a half dozen players that were on the football team that are now playing on the basketball team. And so for Coach Perry and company, he said those guys taking just a little bit longer than normal to get ready, but he thought they were and played pretty well against Mansfield Legacy. And for the Turner coach, it's Eric Costa, his first year as the head coach for the R.L. Turner Lions. In his first season, John Nelson will talk more about him as the game unfolds. I think we're about ready to jump center stage and get this thing underway here at Irving High School. And as I say that, I think the official scorekeepers are making sure all the numbers are correct. And with the call, John Nelson.
All right, Rob, Anthony Union in the jump circle for Irving. Devontae Mirage, number 23 for the R.L. Turner Lions. This one swatted out of bounds. And it'll belong to the visitors from Carrollton as Arnold Serrano across the way, number 10, will dump it in play. R.L. Turner 0-1 on the year, coming off of a loss last week to Garland, 63-41. Over and back call on the guard, Bryce Walker. And we'll see our first possession for the Irving Tigers. And pushing up court is Trey Nelson. Nelson and Anthony Union, the 1-2 punch in the early goings this year for the Tigers as they flip it up top to Nelson. Nelson lets fly a three and connects. Trey Nelson, coming off a 19-point game, gives Irving an early 3-0 lead. On the chase, Ken Johnson gets it in the corner baseline as Mirage regains possession underneath. And a 3-2 contest.
Well, that's a nice play by Devontae there. First of all, he almost lost control of the feed pass and went baseline, almost lost it there, and still came up with the 2 points.
Mirage, one of seven seniors. Bailey Wilson from the dotted line. A Williams, Bailey, wide receiver on the football team, and the Tigers on top by three.
That John just pleaded for them to throw to week in and week out.
Especially the last two games of the year, he was wide open and had a pretty productive last game of the year. Handoff, Mraz looking, his double team flips it out high as Serrano goes left side, and a three pulled in by Ken Johnson. Johnson, a senior, as each team now has connected on a three. Stokes, right side. This is Radford underneath, and an extra step on Anthony Union, the 6'1 sophomore. He'll give it up. And a chance for Lions to take the lead for the first time.
Well, something we haven't seen a lot of Coach Perry's teams in the last few years, and that's a little backcourt pressure, full court pressure.
Jordan Watson over the timeline, fires over to Ken Johnson.
Took a step.
A couple of turnovers here in the last 15 seconds for either team.
Well, it's early. It's only the second game of the year. Coach Perry said that he thought Mansfield Legacy took them a little too lightly, and he was able to sneak up on them.
Won that game 71-61, contact and a push on Mirage. Mirage a little too close to Kobe Stokes, number 24.
You know, the entire crew and ourselves as well, hoping that this group of officials do not call the game quite as tight as we saw last week in ICTN against that Nimitz game. Good grief.
Well, I gave him a wishbone. It is Thanksgiving season, so I gave him a wishbone. I got the long end, so we have maybe a little say-so. if you go by the old folks' tale, and using the body well, leaning in with Stokes and draws the foul.
Yeah, that was a good call. I mean, he went after three players, and not one of those Lion defenders was able to establish underneath, and he was able to split the zone. Watch it here. Goes past Mraz. Johnson tried to draw the charge, but he hadn't planted himself yet.
Second team foul on R.L. Turner at the line. 4-2 is Kobe Stokes. This one stays down, almost rimmed out. Stokes, one of three sophomores this year for head coach Stephen Perry. He's got six seniors and five juniors. Kobe Stokes scoring 13 in that win over Legacy. Irving had four players in double figures that game. Cans them both. And the lead at two. Backcourt pressure, trying to get to Watson to overcommit. Watson challenged by Garcia. Left side open for a minute, Serrano. Now kicks it out around the circle they go. Watson looking, bounce pass in the corner. Collected, turning, no shot. And off in the corner. Jared Clay in the contest, number 34. And as soon as they start the drive, R.L. Turner turns it over right in front of head coach Stephen Perry. That one on Ken Johnson.
That must not have been Serrano's shot to take in that series where they
kind of wonder if they're trying to go to somebody else.
Yeah, he was wide open on the wing.
Inbounds it comes to Trey Nelson, 5'11 junior. As Rob said, the Tigers have had their way in the last four meetings against the Lions, having won three of the last four. On the run and posting up with Clay. And the third team foul upcoming on R.L. Turner. We'll see Trey Nelson at the stripe for a couple.
Well, you can see what the Tigers are trying to do here in the early go, and I think that's forced the issue and drive the paint.
And Trey will have one more, and Irving 3 of 3 now and foul shooting. Irving High, regional champions back in 09. District 7-6A, R.L. Turner now in District 14-5A. This one bumps the rim. It's kicked and finally collected by Bryce Walker.
Sportscaster jinx.
Never fails. The necklace was snapped. Clay on the right wing. Here's a handoff to Bryce Walker. Walker can't get around Nelson as they reset it. Johnson trying to get it underneath. And off the fingertips of Bryce Walker. A little bit too close for comfort there in the turnover.
You know, Dan Fouts was shaming the play-by-play guy in the pro game on Sunday that Dick Enberg, his longtime partner at one time for Dick Fouts, said he believed in the sportscaster's jinx.
So he bought into it early.
He did.
Nelson goes up, has it blocked by Ken Johnson, out of bounds, off of whom? Off of Irving. Last touch by the Tigers in the corner. Trey Nelson.
Atkins in, number 20. Sophomore for R.L. Turner. And once again, the Lions, although it's not a full court back press, they are playing a tough man-to-man.
And off to Serrano. Looking, dumps it off behind him to Watson. Bryce Watson had a pretty nice game in one of the two against the Tigers last year. Fires it over to Watson, who in turn gets it up high to Walker. Blocked away and picked off by Angel Garcia. Garcia to Bailey Williams. Williams goes up in his foul box. Play the trail man.
Nice fast break move. Nice pass. Williams couldn't finish it off, but was hacked. Watch again the pressure in the backcourt. It all starts with Garcia with the steal. Pressure coming from behind to Walker. He finds a trailing Williams, but he'll go to the line.
And Bailey fills up the first, 6'4 senior. And the lead at four. And And the second as good as the first. And the Tigers now 5 of 6 from the line, kicked out of bounds in the backcourt.
Coach Perry said the one thing that really surprised him in that opening night game against Legacy is just how hard his kids fought. You know, it seems pretty common rhetoric, if you will, by coaches or coach speak, but he said that he was impressed with the fact that they came out so intense in their play that pleased him the most in that win.
Jordan Watson was trapped, and Clay just happened to be at midcourt. Back to Clay and through. Everybody, nobody touched it for Irving, and another R.L. Turner turnover.
They looked a little disjointed on that last series, Turner did.
A 5-point cushion, 3:33 to go, on the way with a three and nothing but the bottom of the net. Trey Nelson connects on his second three, and head coach Eric Costa will call a timeout.
Well, the thing about that play is Trey was able to work free, not any pressure whatsoever, and he was able to get the ball off quickly. Look, the nice drive there by Stokes left Nelson wide open, and second three be here in the first quarter.
Bryce Walker got there just a tad late, and the Tigers have opened up an 8-point lead. Again, coming off a win over Legacy, 71-61. R.L. Turner dropping their season opener to the Owls of Garland, 63-41.
You know, in the JV game before this, Turner won 72-63, 135 total points. Ironically, they had scored 67 total points. So just a 1 point over the double, just doubling it from halftime to the final. We've gone about 3 weeks and seen games not have that many combined points in our games.
Yeah, the final 8 minutes, it was just basket trading time. Head coach Eric Costa for the Lions, as Rob said, in his first year, he was at Barbara Bush Middle School in Carrollton for 14 years. And now the head coach for R.L. Turner in District 14-5A. They drop down in classification. Bryce Walker still in the backcourt. Here's Jordan Watson. Watson picked up by Garcia. Machuca in number 24. This one off the bottom of the rim, picked up on one bounce by Garcia. Well, the Lions have already used 9 different players here in the first 5 minutes. Baseline in the corner, Anthony Union, and Union with an extra step just pounds his right fist in the lane.
The thing I've noticed about the Lions here in the first 5 minutes, John, is they don't contest a lot of shots on the perimeter. Irving has had some clean shots. I think Union had a chance to shoot that three ball instead of driving that time.
Machuca behind the back trying to get an open spot to the left side and misfires from about 18 underneath. Serrano misses out of bounds and off of R.L. Turner. 2:40 to go in a fast-moving first quarter, 13-5 in favor of the Tigers. And we see Romeo Radford in for the first time, number 11. Radford, a 5'10 senior guard.
I can't hear
Trey Nelson.
Can't get over how many players each team has on the bench. You know, we've seen the girls' teams for Nimitz and MacArthur with like maybe 5 to choose from, and these guys gotta have like 10 each.
8-footer can by Williams. Bailey with a nice open jumper. And the lead now at 10. Williams with his 5th point. On the way and on the board, Bryce Walker, his first 2. And the lead at 8 with under 2 minutes to go in the first. Looking for Stokes, backing it out is Radford. Entry pass to Bailey Williams, a little give and go, hook shot on the way, and off the mark, Garcia.
If you're the Lions, do you keep trying to take that charge? It hadn't worked tonight.
Serrano bumped, jarred loose of the ball, they get it back. And they'll reset it thanks to Ronnie Atkins, number 20. Watson up high with a minute 21 to go. Side court, Watson takes it deep and delivers a little short. Twisting free is Nelson. Trey hands it off. Another handoff off the glass. A three-player pass, and Cody Stokes with his fourth point.
That was nice. Nicely done. They didn't dribble. It's pass, pass, pass. Found the man on the weak side.
Three players involved in all. Serrano grabs the pass, gives it up high to Machuca. He misses. Long rebound, Serrano. And right in front of the Irving bench, and the Lions will get it back. Number 15, in for the first time, Micah Brooks. Brooks, a junior. Wraparound pass over to Serrano, back in the paint, the drive as Machuca, Linnell Machuca, takes it to the rim and draws the foul. First team foul by Irving.
And the first trip to the free throw line for the Lions tonight.
Linnell Machuca, a 5'11 junior, trying to eat into that 10-point deficit. Lobs up the first and has it. Last year, the Lions averaged right at 42 points a game in district. They finished 3-11, only won three district games. But so did Irving last year.
Yeah, they were pretty equal, wouldn't you say?
Uh-huh. 2-for-2 from the line and the lead at 8. See if the Tigers milk it all the way and go for the last shot. Trey Nelson. He'll spread the floor with Stokes. Kobe Stokes on the right side. There he is with 15 seconds. The return feed to Nelson. With 10, they start the 5-second count with 7. Trey Nelson underneath and with 5. R.L. Turner, coach, thought he may have walked first. Was hit on the arm. Team foul number 5, and the Tigers have 5 seconds to get a shot off. In close, Micah Brooks. And Brooks is fouled in a basket and one with 2 seconds.
Although those kind of plays will drive you crazy as a coach. Coach Costa and his guys giving up 2 fouls in about 10-second span, one of which might lead to a 3-point play.
Micah Brooks trying to fill it up. Short with 1 and would not have counted. And that is the end of the first 8 minutes here at Irving High. Our score in this non-district matchup, the Irving Tigers 19, the R.L. Turner Lions 9 on the ICTN Game of the Week.
Do you think so?
John Nelson back with Rob Wilman. Our first look at the Irving Tigers this year. Team that went 8-19 overall a season ago. They'll insert Jesse Aranda. Aranda, number 5. In for the first time, senior guard at 5'10". This is he at side court. In close, turning a 360 spin, and nothing but net. Romeo Radford in the paint. And the lead now at 12 at 21-9. Contact in the front court as Watson trying to get away from Aranda. Team foul number 2, an on-shooting foul on Irving.
Well, apparently Coach Perry is trying to play as many guys. This is the time to do it. We went that first quarter not too bad, personal foul-wise. Coach Perry said he didn't see a difference in officiating as far as close calls are concerned in that legacy game.
It's only November, so.
But that game last week, he traveled.
There's a ways to go. Air ball pumped up, getting it right back, and missing is Watson. And here come the Tigers on the run. Radford Radford all the way. Romeo Radford with his fourth point and a 23-9 lead.
Kind of jettisoned off, didn't he, about the top of the key.
A 14-point lead. Atkins. Atkins, he can't pull the trigger. He turns, sends it over to Serrano. Serrano is bumped hard on the front and from the back. And for the Tigers, team foul number four, Bailey Williams back in at 6'4". And also Anthony Union, number one, the sophomore. Down by 14, trying to create just something here. They let it fly and getting it back, turning, shooting, and a push right at the Watson release.
Yeah, Watson used his shoulder to create separation on the baseline. He did well to get the offensive rebound, but then he pushed off with the shoulder trying to create some space to put the ball back up and got caught.
Jose Greco, number 33. In for the Lions. Side court, Aranda back in the middle. Radford, and a handoff.
There's your charge, John.
Anthony Union with a headbutt and a chest bump as well.
Serrano's like, finally, I've hit the floor about eight times tonight, and nothing's been called, but this time he really did have position on the base.
So it goes against the Tigers and Anthony Union, team foul number five. R.L. Turner with seven team fouls. There's a wet spot right near that baseline area. And Serrano to inbound. Here's the trouble, though. R.L. Turner has had trying to get free in the backcourt. Serrano still looking.
I thought he's going to throw it to you.
Looking this way, Cortez just throws it up. Bailey Williams reaching in front and knocking it away from Ronnie Atkins, number 20. He's out of bounds at the 50-yard line. Angel Garcia as Trey Nelson comes out. 23-9 in favor of the Tigers, trying to go to 2-0 on the early season. At the free throw line, you saw Linnell Machuca. And Machuca was hit. Team foul number six. So R.L. Turner one away from a one-and-one situation. Serrano to play it in. In the corner. Partially blocked. Mismatch there, scooped up by Greco, gives it in the right corner. That three-pointer off the mark, taken by Cortez. Radford has to circle back to get it. Just underway in the second quarter. Lions have yet to score. Three-pointer short. There's Cortez with a short rebound in front of Garcia. Looking for Serrano. Three-pointer, left elbow. That one curls out as Atkins let it fly. Open, Bailey Williams behind the back. And a short handoff to Xavier Radford. Radford number two. Saved on the side by Union. Xavier Radford in the paint, gets it right back, second effort. Xavier Radford, the sophomore, and it's 25-9.
It's like an assist to himself after missing that first one.
Cortez, bounce pass to Machuca, up high. And this one away from the ball.
Offensive
foul. That
one
on R.L. Turner.
Yep.
That is the eighth. Will not result in a 1-1. Devontae Mraz in, number 23.
1-1 now, the scorekeeper's telling us. And he's putting up the 1-1 again. The officials aren't
That's the eighth, but.
Yeah, one more, not now.
Bradford, bounce pass.
They jumped the gun a little bit.
Yeah. Xavier, number two, puts it on the floor, picked up by Ken Johnson, goes outside the Union, now across the other way. Romeo Radford on Cortez. Underneath, and there's Bailey Williams from Radford. Radford on the assist.
Bailey looks a little more comfortable this year out on the court.
Shovel pass, top of the key. And a three taken, a miss by Greco, and a loose ball foul with 4:03 to go here in the second.
Anthony Union, the 6'1 sophomore, called with going over the back. You'll get that call against you, what, 8 out of 10 times.
It'll put Devontae Moraz, a 6'1 senior, at the line. And the Lions missing the front end of a 1-1. They are now 2 of 3 from the line, under 4 minutes to go. Play broken up on the floor and a tie up, and wrestling it away is Moraz. Possession arrow favors the Lions.
Those tie ups get tricky sometimes, don't they? Well, they're not even going to call a tie up. They're going to call a personal foul.
It's going to be a foul on
yep.
Irving, and that'll put the Lions at the line. Team foul number 8.
I think they ended up calling that against Garcia.
Right back at the stripe is Moraz, number 23.
See what happens when we start bragging about the lack of whistles on fouls. Now both teams in the bonus. It's your fault, John.
Well, we peaked a little early, but we had the right to. I mean, we had every
we were
right.
Excited.
Back in a starter, Trey Nelson, number 10, and Romeo Radford comes out. A break next week on ICTN. We go the junior college routes in a couple of weeks at North Lake. A 16-point lead. Trey Nelson stops, gets it outside. As Radford goes deep, misses. Bailey Williams gets a rebound. Baseline right, that misses. Tipped back to Williams. A third chance for the Tigers. A no-look pass underneath. Garcia shot block, gets it back. It would have counted, but we'll see Angel Garcia at the line. Good sequence there. Hard-nosed play by the Tigers to keep it alive and above the rim.
Right, good sequence indeed, John. A lot of hustle involved. Garcia had it blocked, fought far, and put his follow-up up before he got fouled.
So Angel Garcia at the line for a pair. Irving with 8 points this quarter, and the Lions with just 2. Bryce Walker, number 3, who started back in. And Garcia will line up the second. A little better stroke, down and through. In the lead at 17. Blocked at midcourt. Bailey Williams all over. Number 33, Jose Greco. And in for the first time is Sebastian Dimas. A lineman off the Tiger football team. Dimas, number 35. 3:20 as Johnson goes left side. Cortez didn't have a good look, headed this way, and saved on the wing by Garcia, just flips it back into the court of play. Cross court, 3 on the way and a little short. That was Stokes who took the shot. Under 3 minutes.
Great hustle by Garcia just to save that.
Ken Johnson shoots and gets over Stokes. Johnson's 5th point and the lead at 15. Garcia, right hash mark, lost it, now regains possession. Nice defense by Greco. Underneath, open, and missing is Stokes. He had the shot.
He did.
All the way, and short is Johnson with 2:14 to go in the first half. Waist-high catch by Radford, and Radford over Walker. They like that, 30-13. Tip, turnover. Radford, can opener. Making him pay for the miss.
Well, he made sure the second time. He tried it the first time, had so much strength, he was still able to force it over the iron. And then with a nice steal, his second trip down the court, he got up just a little bit higher to slam that one home.
32-13 as the Tigers pulling away here in the first half.
Pressure D, that's the whole name of the game here for Irving.
Yeah, they do look sharp on the defensive side. Cortez takes the handoff, gets around one, too much on it. Nelson ahead, watch, and the body lean in on Greco, who got him on the way up. Stokes will shoot twice. Just a self-defense move by the defender just to get any part of him. And Kobe Stokes, 2-for-2 at the line. Coming off a 13-point game last week. And one more. We'll see the Tigers later in the year in District 7 6A play. And the second of two, and what do we have, a lane violation? Yep. Lane violation on the Tigers, so do not count that one. The lead stays at 19. A minute and a half to go. In the corner was Atkins. Oh, any kind of pressure, Robin, the Lions just come unraveled.
Yeah.
Really can't contend with it. And a timeout taken here.
One thing I've noticed in this game is the fact how well the Tigers have put the pressure on R.L. Turner. At first, it just started with a little man-to-man in the backcourt. Now they've thrown some traps out there as well. As you take a look at Eric Costa in his first year as a varsity coach, I asked Coach Perry, I said, you know, he was a middle school coach for a long time, and he looked at me like he knew where I was headed with that question. And as Coach Perry does so well, he smiled at me and said, that doesn't mean anything. He goes, they thought enough of him. Put him in the head coaching spot.
They'll play the likes of Little Elm, McKinney North, Prosper.
Boy, he took over the head coaching job at the right time, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Lake Dallas and Newman Smith also in the district. So we hope Eric Costa does well at R.L. Turner. Going to get a taste of varsity basketball contact. He had Johnson and Radford there locked up. And a blocking call.
Yeah, Xavier Radford just a little too aggressive on that defensive side.
It'll put Ken Johnson, one of seven seniors, at the line for R.L. Turner. Romeo Radford is set to come back in. If he makes this, he's going to come in now. And that means Trey Nelson comes out.
Yeah, that district you were talking about, 14-5A. Here's Prosper all of a sudden in 5A. And like the third largest school in that district. Talk about it. As you take a look there, Creekview out of Carrollton, McKinney North, Newman Smith, the two Carrollton schools, and the Colony, who at one time was a bigger school as well. Some demographic changes and some faces you've never seen in 5A before.
17-point lead, touch pass, it goes to Stokes. Gets away from Cortez, now they'll reset it in the middle to Radford. Winding down to a minute. Tigers have never trailed a handoff. Demas wide open from Stokes. And the steal. By Romeo Radford off the glass, two more for Stokes.
Yeah. Stokes says, thank you, Mr. Radford, because that was his hustle in the backcourt that gave him the easy two.
Ahead to Greco. He misses. Rebound Demas, and he's held, trying to get away from Jose Greco, number 33.
This game getting away from the Lions here late in the second quarter. As right now, R.L. Turner doesn't have an answer for the much taller and quicker, more pestier, if you will, defensive unit of Irving High School.
And at the line for the first time, number 35, Sebastian Demas, the junior, misses the first. Second on the way, and that one's a little heavy, and another whistle and
lane violation.
This one on R.L. Turner. So a third chance for Demas. It may have been Walker that jumped the gun for the Lions. Gives Demas a third chance. Okay, let's. That one on Irving, so lane violation on the Tigers.
Maybe on Allen. I think he was the only one at the line.
Ken Johnson almost got away as Radford circled around and almost picked his pocket. Walker with a nice bullet pass inside is broken up and picked up by Stokes. With 12 seconds. Romeo Radford with a floater high above the square. And Walker not set for R.L. Turner. Charged
maybe,
with a block.
Maybe one out of 10 tonight have the Lions been able to draw the charge. They keep trying, I'll give them credit.
And Romeo Radford at the line for the first time. And the Tigers taking no chances. They pull everybody out of the lane as Radford sinks the first of two. That one spins away with 5 seconds. Ken Johnson, will he get it off? He will, lays it up and in. With 1 second, and Ken Johnson scores the final 2 points of the first quarter, but it has been all Irving here in the first 16 minutes. Halftime at Irving High. Our score, the Irving Tigers 37, the Lions of R.L. Turner 17. You're watching the ICTN Game of the Week.
Irving Tigers with a commanding 37-17 halftime lead, pretty much all Tigers, but we do have some highlights as well for R.L. Turner as they tried to make a game of this going baseline. Devonte Meraz and then Ken Johnson with the three-pointer there, leading his team in scoring in the first half. Rice Walker with the pull-up J as well, but pretty much it was the pressure defense for these Tigers, it really made the difference in this ball game. First of all, a three-pointer by Trey Nelson. He had a hot start. And then Kobe Stokes, they finish off the fast break. Nelson, Garcia over to Stokes, nicely done. And then some a little excitement with the fast break. First, Xavier Radford hits the front of the cup and makes it fall and then gets the steal and goes coast to coast. And he makes sure with that one, brings the crowd to their feet in a very good first half and a dominating first half for these Irving Tigers. Johnson, Meraz, Walker, Machuca are your scores for the Lions. For the Tigers, Radford, Williams, Nelson, Stokes, really even those top four. Xavier Radford, Brooks, Demas Garcia, the others rounding out the scoring. Now with the call, here's Mr. Nelson.
All right, Rob, R.L. Turner, and Watson trying to go deep with a three. Their first shot misses of the second half. And Angel Garcia on the other end scores the first two for the Tigers just 21 seconds into the second half, and some contact underneath, and Ken Johnson slow to get up. Johnson may have hit the back of his head on the way down. 9 points so far for the senior. And Rob, they've done a pretty good job on Jordan Watson. Watson, one of their key players, number five, he has yet to score. And at the line is Ken Johnson as the Tigers collect their first team foul of the second half. R.L. Turner, 6 of 7, now make it 7 of 8 in foul shooting. And Ken Johnson, the senior, now in double figures. Rattles the second one through. And we'll see Romeo Radford. 8 different players accounting for the Irving 39 points. It was Watson that had the hot game, one of the two games last year against the Tigers with 19 points. A handoff on the side as Garcia tries to go down low, unable to handle it, is Radford as Garcia sets up on the defensive side. 20-point lead at 39-19. R.L. Turner held to just 8 points in that second quarter. Open underneath, a shot high off the glass as Arnold Serrano connects his first two. 39-21, cross court to Nelson, now on the side to Radford. Trey in the corner, guarded by Walker. He'll take the three over Walker, too much on it. Caught underneath by Ken Johnson. The drive over Bailey Williams. And a nice finish by Devontae Mraz.
Well, maybe the halftime break cooled off these Tigers and invigorated the Lions, because they come out scoring 6 here right off the bat. And we'll take a look at the last bucket. Nothing really fancy. Mraz with the head fake on Stokes and goes up against Williams off the glass, and a couple of points for the forward here in the ball game.
Nice 6-2 run by R.L. Turner to begin the second half. They'll play a couple of tournaments before heading into district play, likewise for Irving.
Picks in that district they were talking about in 15 or 14-5A, McKinney North, Little Elm, Prosper, and Creekview are your top four picks. There's also Newman Smith, the Colony, and of course these Lions in that district.
A couple of Dallas Cowboys make Little Elm and Prosper their home. That's one of the hot spots in the area now.
Prosper for sure. Salina probably pretty happy with that, because for a while there, Salina was starting to grow and everyone was leaving Frisco and heading further north. But now they've taken a detour to Prosper.
Romeo Radford flips it cross court to Stokes. This is Garcia. He's shut down. Gets it again on the right wing. Lobs it in for Bailey Williams. Spot Stokes. And Stokes underneath, his 8th point. It is 41-23. And Johnson trying to split the defenders, namely number 4, Levante Briggs, who has just come on, and Romeo Radford.
Briggs, one of those football players, trying to make the transition to basketball.
1 of 6 seniors. Here's Ken Johnson. Johnson looks up, turns, no opening. In the middle of Watson. Outside they go. Machuca, and this three misses. Not Machuca, beg your pardon, that's Mraz. Mraz misses a three. They made one in the first half. And the foul, the hold called underneath on Irving, team foul number 2.
John Irving just doesn't look as sharp here to start the third quarter. They look a little out of sync.
Well, they ordered carry out.
Are they bloated? Is that what you're trying to tell me? They got bloated during halftime?
Not enough electrolytes. Ken Johnson, second of two. And the lead at 17. It was 19-9 at the end of the first quarter. 37-17 at the break as they go around the horn. Briggs. And Stokes. See if he can do anything with it in the corner to Radford. Back to Stokes. And backs it out. He's fronted by Walker. Garcia rolls it in. It's through the legs of Bailey Williams. Ken Johnson has the save, and then he's kicked by Radford.
That was an aggressive pass in between three Lions that last time that led to that turnover.
That's the 14th foul on Irving. Briggs will come out. And here's Jordan Watson. Has been held scoreless coming off an 11-point game last week. Open and creating the space is Mraz, but he walked with it. Turns it over with 5:05 to go in the third. Radford angles to the left side, picked up by Ken Johnson. Over to Stokes. To Union, and Union goes up as challenged by Arnold Serrano.
Did he get the charge this time?
I think he may have leaned into him. Offensive charge.
Yeah, second time. Serrano's about 2 out of 6 on trying to draw the charge.
Another look, Anthony Union coming off a...
Hey, that right leg's dragging.
Just a little bit behind him. Union scoring 20 his last game. And as yet to score, but his team leading by 17. Little flip to Watson. Watson in and out from about 23. They get it back, the drive, and Bailey Williams and the teammate over the top of Ken Johnson. The teammate was Radford as they sandwiched Johnson, and he's slow to get up.
Yeah, Radford's going to be called for the foul. Bailey had nothing but ball. And the penalty, or the personal foul, goes against Romeo.
A rules infraction.
Yes.
Ken Johnson, number one, at the line. And kind of backs away as they try to get a spot. That.
Where's those little where's the little youngsters with the mops that run out real quick and dry the court in between plays?
It's kind of like a Swifter, but it's round. Kind of like a pie shell
Swifter
mop that they use.
A pie shell Swifter.
Yeah.
With a microfiber towel.
Bailey Williams comes out, number 33. As Ken Johnson tries to hit his second, he's perfect. Has done well from the free throw line. And the lead at 15. He's 8 of 9 in foul shooting. Stokes hangs on the rim. Loose, run down by Garcia. Here's Stokes. Up and down, hands it off to Trey Nelson, lost it. Ahead to Ken Johnson. Johnson over Stokes, and Stokes got the ball, and out of bounds is Radford.
I think Xavier could have let that one go. I don't think he needed to save it. As Johnson lost control in the paint, as we look at it here. Yeah, I think it went off his leg. He didn't see it, he was blocked off.
Johnson has taken a beating here in his third quarter. The miss and the rebound pulled down by Micah Brooks, number 15. Nelson hands it off, and the contact and the charge on Trey Nelson.
Mraz took one for the team there on the baseline. And I think that was a legitimate charge.
That was, yeah. Nelson leaned and got all of it. Seventh team foul in this quarter. Running away from it, losing possession is Watson. Picked up by Brooks. Still loose, and then you had Watson in a leg whip with Garcia, number 21.
Trey Nelson, number 10 for Irving High. You should take a look at Coach Costa. He's going to be called for the hold, and I think he wants an explanation of the call. Well, are they flipping it the other way?
They had put off the 18 foul on Irving, and that changed it, and we'll see Jordan Watson at the line.
The bonus already.
Man, Jordan Watson, senior, at the line for the first time. Had 19 against the Tigers last year in one of the two district games. Again, both teams went 3-11 last year. Never up, never in. And the miss with 3.5 to go in the third. Stokes inside as Brooks battling hard for position, backing in, and then Walker went around the other side.
As Mraz with the personal foul.
First team foul on R.L. Turner in this quarter. Open, Garcia, and that one rims out. Tigers landed a couple of threes in the first half. Jordan Watson from the right elbow misses. On the run is Xavier Radford. Over to Stokes. Stokes from the dotted line, a little short. Came up a tad short on the delivery, and Mraz has the rebound. Under 3 minutes. Watson working on Nelson and palmed it, turned it over. Gives it up with 2:47 to go in the third.
You know, John, in the first half, Turner had 7 free throw attempts. They've already had 6, just in the third quarter already. Irving had 15 attempts at the free throw line in the first half. They have yet to go to the line.
Bounce pass underneath the Brooks. Off the back iron, trying to tip it in was Garcia. So the Lions, they get a stop. Can they convert? Short. That fired up by Jordan Watson.
Irving with only 4 points in the third quarter, John, after scoring 19 and 18 respectively in the first and second.
They're going to let Bailey Williams come on. And Brooks comes out. So Bailey Williams, they got the tall guys out here now. Picked off, Radford. Radford hands it off. Open and missing is Trey Nelson. They get it back. Underneath, and Trey would like to have that one. One more time.
Not laughing at Trey, I'm laughing at Coach Perry on the sideline, rubbing his face.
Garcia in the corner misses. Rim high with a rebound is Mraz. In traffic, Johnson. Under 2 minutes left here in the third. Top of the key. Closer, double pump. And finishing it off is Mraz. 41-28, Mraz with 8 points. Garcia grabs it, now back in the middle of Radford. Left of the circle, Nelson. Baseline underneath, Garcia, and it goes. Almost spun out.
Good job by Angel working free on the baseline.
15-point lead, nice drive, and the finish by Jordan Watson, and the senior collects his first bucket of the night. That's the guy they were counting on perhaps to carry much of the load tonight with Ken Johnson. And the lead has been shaved to 13.
Delay of game call. Coming out of the basket hitting the ball. Delayed game against Turner. They also have Harper just checked in.
We've seen a delay of the game and a technical foul before the game has started in the last 2 weeks. Going for the steal is Watson. Off the chin as Nelson really sideswiped. Number 40 had just come on.
Yeah, Harper.
Cam Harper, a senior. Team foul number two, and Trey Nelson at the line.
That's one of those plays where you can tell the guy's been on the bench for 2.5 quarters of play. Excited to get out there, a little over-aggressive.
His expression kind of tells a story. Nelson cans the first of two. It is 44-30. Stoppage of play for a quick check. Everything all right? As Nelson will shoot for point number 10 and have it. He's in double digits. Lead back at 15. Linnell Matuka. Crossover behind the back. Lost it. Slips down. The steal by Radford. And the finish.
Oh, he's making a living with those shots.
And the chase is on. Violation is Watson. He couldn't get free and a timeout taken. Was in trouble. As a good 5 seconds one off, you have 10 to get it across half court.
Well, Radford, he comes out of the pack. One-handed flush and 2-1 game. Camera guys always like to have an over-under before the ball game. How many slams? What's the over-under? I usually say just one to play it safe, but
we've had three.
You count the one where it kind of hit the rim and pushed in, you don't count that one, do you?
Mm-mm. It's got to go down. We're not, no gimme putts, no in the leather.
Irving picks.
Got to go in the cup.
Irving picks in this district, a very tough district. Cedar Hill, Duncanville, South Grand Prairie, and the Eagles of DeSoto, the top four teams. Picked by the Texas Association of Basketball Coaches and District 7, 6A by far. One of the toughest in the state of Texas in 6A.
We had a battle every night, every Tuesday and Friday. Once district play begins. So they have their full complement with 20 seconds left here in quarter number three. Underneath the rim, it'll be R.L. Turner's ball, number 40, Cam Harper to dump it in. Still a holdup at the scorer's table. Okay, here we go. Harper shoves it in play. Clock hadn't started, now it does. Jordan Watson. Watson and up with Garcia. He gives it up with 14 seconds left.
I think the officials thought that the clock that runs during timeouts where it counts down from 60 had stopped at 20, not realizing there was 20 seconds left in the quarter. And that's when they finally figured that out. They decided to play ball, but like you said, and again, look, the clock starts about a second or two late every time.
Trey Nelson. With 5 seconds in the corner, Garcia's three short with one, and just a heave hole from about 75 feet hits a rafter, and we'll go to the fourth. A 17-point Irving lead on our ICTN Game of the Week. We had head to the fourth quarter, it has been all Irving here in this non-district matchup on top by 17. They have led by as many as 20 on a couple of occasions. Tigers still with 2 3-pointers. They haven't really had to have that to take a lead in this game, and they'll touch it first to begin the fourth quarter. Trey Nelson across the way, Stokes on one wing, here he is. Quickly a handoff to Garcia, looking for Bailey Williams. Bounce pass, Nelson. He's shut down. Stokes, and Stokes, as soon as he got around Cam Harper, the whistle blows, and the block. Third team foul on R.L., the fourth team foul on the Lions. Double pump underneath, and Stokes, he got Mirage to commit with a head bob. And Kobe Stokes at the line where he is 2 of 4.
Yeah, the 6'1 sophomore, he's your muscle. He's the guy that can press inside and move some bodies around.
And Stokes misfires on the first. Unofficially, the Tigers 9 of 17 in foul shooting. Here's the follow-up as you see the trajectory, and he sticks it. Substitution, Arnold Turner, Arnold Serrano, who started in for Mraz. So Coach Perry across the way, 7 playoff appearances under the 13-year coach. In the corner and off of R.L. Turner. I think it went off of Ken Johnson. It'll belong to Irving.
Well, let's see if the Tigers can pick up where they left off late in the third quarter. It seemed like it took them about 6 minutes to find their groove and stride again defensively. That really turned things and pressured the Lions into mistakes in the third quarter.
Scored 71 in the season opener. A leaner inside by Stokes, and Williams has a rebound and the putback. His 9th point. Atkins on the run, and then closing the gap, Stokes and Nelson.
One thing I think Kobe has to work on, he is aggressive, and he will commit a foul or two.
He just did, the team's 9th.
Yeah, it's free throw city for the Lions from here on out.
We see Ronnie Atkins at the line, sophomore. Arnold Turner, 11 of 14 from the stripe. Williams got in front of Harper to get the loose ball. And then the push off by Harper. Not much of one, but is hit with a foul.
He's played about 2 minutes tonight and has picked up 2 fouls.
Rogelio Vera in number 12 for the first time, a guard. So Vera in for the first time. Underneath and a nice pass, Garcia able to spot Radford underneath.
Xavier with 10 points coming off the bench.
And a 22-point lead, the steal. It goes. He just got it high enough. Xavier Radford. And an insurmountable 24-point lead over the head of Machuca underneath. He let it fly, did Johnson. It somehow went in, had no vision of the basket at all. Yes, Johnson threw it up. And it landed.
Hey, there's your highlight for the Lions right there.
There it is.
Going baseline on Garcia. Williams tries to block it, and he just throws it up over his shoulder and goes in.
So Ken Johnson at the stripe trying to complete a 3-point play. And they do. Off the bench, number 11, Ulysses Cortez.
Every time I hear a whistle after a free throw, I think a lane violation. We've had so many in the game.
We've had 3 so far. In front of the bench, Garcia. Across the way, and Radford can't shoot. And from the back, Nelson has it knocked away by Johnson, but he also may have gotten the top of the hand. Nope. All ball.
I don't think any of the officials saw where the ball went. They all looked at each other. No one was there to help, so they just said, okay.
Is that kind of like picking up a check at the end of a meal? You look at each other. Well, I
to see who's going to pick it up.
I left mine in the car, and
oh yeah, the old I left my wallet. Who leaves their wallet in the car? You know what's going to happen? It's going to get stolen. No one does that.
A little short on the ones. I got to get ones. Well, yeah.
Well, what you do is
we'll
you,
wait
you,
while you get the ones.
That's right. You make a mental note. And next time you see them, you make sure they have their wallet before you sit down.
What about a money clip? The steal by Serrano. And here come the Lions the other way. Why not? Cortez fails to ring the bell, and underneath, Briggs has the loose ball. Kobe Stokes. Stokes working on Greco. They reverse it over to Radford. Xavier up top to Stokes. Intended for Garcia, broken up. And the steal taken away by Rogelio Vera. And then Johnson to the backcourt with Garcia as it goes out of bounds.
Thing about the district that Irving has to face, and we showed you who the top four teams could possibly be. I mean, you're going to have to bring your A game every night when you play these teams. There's not a lot of gimmies like there were last year. And if you want to be competitive, much less win, you've got to have – everything's got to be working.
So bring your what?
Your A game.
I've got A game, but it may not be up to the level that you need to pull away from this district. Ken Johnson still has it. A little out of control and throws up his second prayer. Ken Johnson as the Tigers try to pull away Radford with 4:38 to play.
Watch him make a move to the hoop. Stops. Tosses up with a nice little reverse spin on it. Kisses the glass for two, and we've got a technical foul against one of the Lions.
R.L. Turner hit with the tee, and Kobe Stokes will shoot the technical free throws with 4:38 to play. Ken Johnson being...
They've already been warned once about a delay.
And they'll get the ball and the lead at 20. They'll have it in front of us. Xavier Radford. Send it ahead to Romeo Radford. Briggs hands it off inside. And DJ Stevenson with his first shot of the night.
Which DJ is that? Watch him there with the left hand.
Is it the quarterback?
Or the defensive back?
Or the D-back. And Stevenson misses. To the corner, getting to it first was Stevenson. Runs it down about 15 feet away. And the drive in the basket by Radford. Romeo's seventh point. Contact. The jump in, Watson. Right there, Briggs.
Stevenson thought he had the charge. He says, look, I've been sitting on the bench for 3.5 quarters. I've been watching what's going on. I'm going to draw the foul.
And Jordan Watson at the line for the second time. Zeman Allen in for the first time. Allen, a 6-foot senior. And before the shot, lane violation on R.L. Turner.
There we go. That's what I was used to hearing.
You are correct. That's the fourth. A 23-point bulge. DJ Stevenson, short. Briggs grabs it underneath. Here's Briggs with a floater. Coach Perry beginning to clear the bench. Jordan Watson lets fly with about a 23-footer. Team three-pointer number two. His sixth point. It is 59-39. Briggs outside to Zeman Allen. Radford to Stevenson. Briggs can't have it drop.
Well, he let it fly, didn't he?
Trying to hit the long three. Bounces off the back iron as Cortez misses. Ahead to DJ, waits for the defender to clear and scores. DJ Stevenson, 4 points off for the bench. It is 61-39. Irving Tigers will start the year at 2-0. Watson has it curl out underneath. And the block, number 33. That's Guerco. And
blew a tire in the process.
And he almost lost a shoe in the process as well. So he'll go to the line with 2:45 to go. R.L. Turner will fall to 0-2. Again, coming off of a loss to Garland, and that's how many points they scored, 41.
Well, it's average. Not like they've had a soft schedule so far.
Outnumbered, it goes in for Aranda. Over the top, and the recovery by Mraz. He goes into double digits with 2:20 to go. .16 points this quarter for the Tigers. Briggs behind the back, he misses. And then all kinds of contact with Mraz and Walker as well. 13 points also in this quarter for R.L. Turner. So the foul on Irving and the double bonus. And number 23, Devontae Mraz at the stripe.
Last time these two teams played, it was 64-44. We're almost there now.
Connects on the first. 11 for the senior. 7 seniors, 4 juniors, 4 sophomores this year on the varsity. Lands them both. Briggs lost it, picked up, blocked as Walker tried to send it ahead on the side to Johnson with 2:05 to play. And adjacent to head coach Eric Costa, that's where Walker inbounds. Gets it right back and misses. Got the handoff from Johnson. Devontae Briggs, side court, takes it to the left of the lane and misses. Waiting for it underneath was DJ Stevenson. And with a minute 51 to go, the 19th foul committed by R.L. Turner.
Well, the players that led in scoring for their team in game one, not quite producing here in game two. Jordan Watson with about 3 points for his Lions, and then Anthony Union, who had 20 against Mansfield Legacy, yet to score.
Yeah, Union is not in the book yet. 9 overall tonight for Irving, and Stevenson rattles out. And at 47, nice handoff, and Watson getting behind the defender. His 8 point, and then Johnson circles around and got Allen as he tried to pull away in a timeout call with a minute 41 to go. Settle him down, he says. Stephen Perry wants to finish I guess fundamentally strong.
Yep, he's sporting the polo or the golf shirt here in the pre-district, but you can bet once district begins, he'll have the suit and tie on. I said, you got to go toe-to-toe with Duncanville and Cedar Hill.
You got to bring out the James K. Wilson.
You got to have the nice suit.
He buttons that top button. Has that top button always fastened. Kind of a Bubba Watson look.
Yeah. Doesn't he know it's like 90 degrees in this gym?
Yeah, it's pretty warm. Late November, Thanksgiving break. High school basketball over the holidays. It's broken up. Irving gets it back. Hand off to Demos. He'll turn, shoot, and score. His fourth point. 65-47. Watson sends it over to Ken Johnson. Johnson off of the hip, fronted by Demos. And hit the deck as soon as he let it go. 75 seconds left here on this November 21st contest.
You know, all Ranchview has to do is increase its enrollment in all the Carrollton schools, although Ranchview is kind of half and half, Irving and Carrollton. You'd have them all in one district with Carrollton, Creek View, Newman Smith, and R.L. Turner in one district. I don't think that's ever happened.
North Lake and Hill College, our next broadcast. 65-49. Then we'll see Nimitz and Mack on December 13th. Another turnover taken away by the Lions. Ken Johnson. Here's Watson in traffic. And Watson over Demos and I think Radford, and the whistle stops play with 58 seconds to go.
It's either Radford or Demos that hacked him across the bridge of the face. It's been a physical game tonight.
Much more in the second half. Jordan Watson, you have him with 10 now?
Let's see, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9 and counting as he misses the second. And then a lane call.
This has to be a record, John.
Man.
Lane violation record.
5.
I feel like we're in double digits. I don't know how you remember 5. It seems more than that.
That's unofficial. And Jordan Watts will have a second chance to go into double figures. And it got it, so he has 10 tonight. But his team down by 14. Little token pressure. Xavier Radford over the timeline. Little shovel pass to Demos waiting. And Demos goes up and is fouled. Got the nice handoff underneath.
That's what happens when you can break the press. It creates opportunities because someone's coming over to double you up. It's like getting one-on-one coverage in football if they blitz.
Well, Allen got it to him in perfect position. Demos will have another shot. So Sebastian, the 6'3 junior, and misses both. Who has it? R.L. Turner, 44 seconds. Watson, a little out of control, is trying to beat the defender, in this case, Zeman Allen. Allen charged with a foul.
Well, the last 4 minutes have been just a free throw fest.
That it has. 8, 9, yeah, too many. And one more for Jordan Watson. As Demos comes out, Bailey Williams in.
Irving just 4 out of 10 from the free throw line here in the second half. Makes him 11 out of 25 for the game.
Watson follow up underneath and then a body block and then a three-pointer fired up and missed. Trey Nelson the worst of it. Oh, he was clotheslined and R.L. Turner able to get a three-point shot off in the process. Watson and then the foul with 34 seconds to go. That's going to put D.J. Stevenson at the line.
The other D.J. Yeah, the compound matters. One is 23, the other's 32. If you're dyslexic or, you know, you have a hard time looking at the numbers, which one's which?
Well, I have a mirror, and it looks like 23. He'll have one more. Outcome not in doubt at all as the Tigers pull everybody out of the lane. DJ, the junior, he hits it, and a route 66 to 52. Half a minute to go, short, Watson misses. And Xavier Radford over half court, has it open, leaves it in the corner and unable to hold on to it, is Romeo Radford with 18 seconds to play. Baseline right, and a nice 17-footer put in by Devontae Mraz. His 14th point with 3 seconds. And that will do it. Or did they call a foul at midcourt? Now you got to let that one go, and that is the end of the game as the Irving Tigers knock off the R.L. Turner Lions 66-54. They go to 2-0. R.L. Turner falls to 0-2. Rob Willman will visit with head coach Stephen Perry. We'll be back with that, plus highlights and final stats as the Tigers win it 66-54. John Nelson back with Rob Willman as a file out of the Irving gym tonight. The Tigers on top, 66-54, a 12-point cushion as they go to 2-0. The R.L. Turner Lions fall to 0-2. Rob Willman with head coach Stephen Perry.
All right, John, thank you very much. Well, you're 2-0 on the year. That's got to feel pretty good.
Actually, it does. Thought the guys came out, got a quick start, playing hard. First half, executed, put the defensive pressure on. Came out in the second half kind of relaxed. We relaxed, they fought back, you know, which was to be expected. We look young, which we are. We got 4 or 5 sophomores on the team, and we got to learn to finish games.
How did you get the focus back in play to get that intensity like you had in the first half?
I think they just woke up. You know, and those were our main guys, our main starters, and they saw, and they stepped up to the challenge, but they're late. They're late. What happened, though, is we subbed. We went deep into our bench, and those guys have to learn that when they come in, they've got to execute, okay? They've got to execute and keep the same intensity, same focus. As well, those guys that came to the bench can't relax. They've got to stay engaged in the game because we may need them.
You have a lot of players to go to. Will you feel comfortable using them, you think, once district rolls around, or is this a process now to where you see whether or not you can?
Exactly. It is a process. Right now, we're allowing kids to play. We're trying to see what we have, just see what kind of pieces we have. But actually, during district play, I think everyone kind of shortens their bench at that time.
You did look really good defensively. In that second quarter, you just kind of seemed to turn up the heat a little bit, and that's got to make you feel pretty good.
Actually, it does. I've been here a number of years, and that's probably been our staples. You know, we want to pick you up full court. Matter of fact, we want to pick you up when you get off the bus. But pick you up full court, pressure you, try to turn you over, try to get some easy scores, and they did that.
Indeed they did. Congratulations, 2-0.
Thank you very much.
All right, appreciate it, Coach. Back to you, John.
All right, Coach, appreciate it very much. The Irving Tigers scoring 29 points in the second half. R.L. Turner lit it up, 37 in half number two, but they trail by 20 at the break. Action here in the fourth quarter. Ken Johnson with a wraparound. He's not finished yet as he throws it up off the glass. Two of his 20 points. That's the guard, the senior guard, Ken Johnson. And for the Irving Tigers, we'll see the drive by Xavier Radford, his third dunk of the night. Radford finished with a dozen points. Here's a follow-up. That came about 3 minutes later in the fourth quarter. And then Stokes and Bailey Williams there for the recovery. Bailey Williams ended tonight with 9 points. Scoring summary tonight for the R.L. Turner Lions, Ken Johnson totaled out 21. Also in double figures, Devontae Mraz and Jordan Watson. They had a couple of three-pointers tonight. Irving had 3 three-pointers. Xavier Radford, Kobe Stokes, and Bailey Williams all in double figures. The game was tied on one occasion. Irving held a 24-point lead at one time and really not a threat tonight to fall behind of R.L. Turner. They had a 20-point lead on two other occasions as 9 different players tonight accounting for the 66 points. Once again, our final score, the Irving Tigers 66, the R.L. Turner Lions 54. For Rob Willman, this is John Nelson. Have a happy and safe Thanksgiving, everyone, and we'll see you next time on our ICTN Game of the Week.